day for spring training baseball in Southwest Florida, as we've got games happening at the same time in Port Charlotte and Fort Myers. If you're stopping by the Charlotte Sports Park for the Red Sox and Rays game that starts in a little less than an hour now, you're going to have some good but warm weather, as during the second half of the game this afternoon, temperatures will be in the low 80s with a touch of humidity as well. Of course, as you know, Charlotte Sports Park here is just to the west and the southwest of the Murdoch area in Charlotte County, where right now radar is not picking up any rain. We're not seeing rain, but we are seeing some smoke here on the Cape Hayes Peninsula just to the south of 776 here near Rotunda. There must be some sort of fire burning here to the south of Rotunda Circle and to the west-northwest of Quail Road based on how the radar is picking up on this smoke plume. And you can see based on how the wind is pushing out of the south, the smell of smoke from that fire will be moving toward the north, closer toward the eastern side of Rotunda Circle. So if you see or smell smoke in that area, that's what it's coming from. Live radar for the rest of the area is pretty quiet here as you check out Lake Okeechobee and Collier and Hendry and Glades counties, and then check in here with a live look from the Gulf of Mexico. Beautiful day right now as seen from the Royal Shell Sundial Resort along the Barrier Islands, with a lot of sunshine here as well. So your forecast today overall looks pretty good and quiet, despite the fact it will be warm here for the end of the month of February standards in Southwest Florida. Later on tonight, numbers aren't going to drop off quite as cool as where they were last night. We'll fall back to the low 60s in our inland communities and then low to mid 60s for spots along into the west of Interstate 75. Now for tomorrow, look for temperatures to top out in the middle 80s right around lunchtime on Tuesday. And in addition to that, we should basically just see a partly sunny to partly cloudy sky. Rain opportunities really aren't very good on Tuesday, but it's tough to rule out maybe a widely isolated shower or two as the day rolls on. The bigger rain opportunities come our direction late on Tuesday night and early Wednesday morning, thanks to this very strong front. And when this very strong front gets here, it's going to bring some very big changes to our weather here in Southwest Florida. One of the biggest changes is how it's going to flip around the winds. Until this front gets here, our winds will be out of the south and the southwest, keeping things mild and a bit on the muggy side. But during the nighttime hours on Tuesday here, that's when this front gets a little closer to us. It'll bring us a line of downpours and thunderstorms during the nighttime hours before you wake up on Wednesday morning. And then as Wednesday rolls along, the actual front will get closer to us, and that will give us a second opportunity for some downpours and some scattered thunderstorms on Wednesday afternoon. Beyond that, the temperatures really start to tumble behind this front. A high of only 67 degrees, in fact, on Thursday, and even colder on Friday. Look at that. We'll begin the day in the low 40s and only top out in the mid 60s, and that's awfully chilly for the end of February into the first couple days of March. So a little cool snap coming our direction here as we get ready to start a brand new month.
All right, Rob. Thank you.